live from Studio 46, this is Good Morning Union Canal.
Good morning, Union Canal, a place where we show respect, show responsibility, show safety, and do our job. Please rise for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag. And now, let's say our Union Canal Creed. Today is a new day to reach my potential. All right, you may be seated. And now, let's get literate. All right, man, 5 years, this is gonna come back to haunt me, I think. All right, well, good morning. Today is Tuesday, March 2nd, 2021. It is still day 4 on the special schedule. That's what's been given by me. Well, today's lunch is Reading Across America Celebration Lunch. Well, that's a mouthful. That's because there is a turkey and or cheese wok-it in my pita pocket. Okay, hop on pop potato soup, one fish, two fish, goldfish crackers, truffula trees and dip. Now you might be confused, what is that? What are we talking about here? What are we eating? Well, don't worry guys, I think what they're actually talking about right there, I think truffula trees are actually just code for broccoli.
My lady, she went downtown, she bought some broccoli. She brought it home. She's chopping broccoli. Chopping broccoli. Chopping broccoli. Chopping broccoli.
All right, there's also redfish, bluefish, jello dessert. Okay, didn't even try to rhyme that one. That's okay. All right, good. On the salad bar, guys, I have a confession. I was wrong. I do admit when I'm wrong, and I was big time wrong. I didn't look at the lunch menu that closely the past year, I guess. I don't know. I just don't really care. But apparently, Uncrustables are no longer served on Wednesdays. They are served on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And this isn't a new thing. This has been happening since at least February, okay? So, my bad, okay? That's my apology to you, okay? So, that being said, the Uncrustable flavor today, oh, guys. Boy, is your mouth going to be watering. Maybe your eyes will be watering too. This is from Myla George, and Myla George submitted a delicious flavor of Uncrustable. Rotten cheese and spoiled milk. You know, those adjectives go a long way. Because if it's just cheese and milk, I mean, that's still pretty gross. But rotten cheese and spoiled milk, that puts it over the top. Okay. But you're not going to put sandwiches of the week over the top because you're not going to put them anywhere because we don't have them anymore. Wish happy birthday to Aviana Sowers. And guys, it is March 2nd, so it's a very important day for birthdays, obviously, because I don't know if you guys knew this, but it's a very special birthday today. A very special public figure has their birthday today, March 2nd. That's right, kids. It is Jon Bon Jovi's birthday.
It's my
Oh, happy birthday, Jon Bon Jovi. Oh, it's Dr. Seuss's birthday, too. if you care about that now, whatever. We'd also like to welcome all of our guest teachers here with us today. Well, today's top stories are, it's Read Across America Week. Obviously, look at this place. There's books. These are called books, kids. You can get them from a library and you can read them. It's a good thing to do. Well, today is Dr. Seuss's birthday celebration. Well, you'll get a chance to listen to a read aloud of Happy Birthday to You by Dr. Seuss. I didn't realize he's the one who wrote that, but I guess he did. Or maybe his estate now owns the rights to it. But anyway, you also get the opportunity, this is a great opportunity here, guys, to draw your own Dr. Seuss hat. These are cool, and you can get to draw one today. And guys, we do need to give a special thank you because the supplies for this little craft were provided by the Cornwall-Lebanon Education Association. Thank you, CLEA. And most importantly, it says it right on here, our great and benevolent leader, Mr. McGinty. His name is on there. It's very important that we mention that Mr. McGinty was crucial to allowing this to happen. Thank you for this wonderful honor you have bestowed upon all of us, great and benevolent leader, Mr. McGinty. You know, I'm so excited to draw a hat. I think I'm going to draw my own hat really right now. I'm going to draw one. This is fun. Clipboard, paper. I'm going to draw one. I think I can draw a pretty good one. Let's see here. I'm going to write on. Let's see. Ooh. Oh, whoa. Wow. Man, that looks good. I'm really proud of that hat. Okay, well, did a good job there. So hopefully you have fun, as much fun as I did drawing your head, okay? Okay. Well, tomorrow is Book Character Day. Oh, guys, you can go to school tomorrow dressed as any character that you want from any of your favorite books. Any of them. Oh, but there are a couple rules. So you can't be someone scary. It's got to be appropriate. No body paint, okay? And most importantly, guys, it specifically says on here, no masks. There'll be no masks at school tomorrow, okay? That's what the paper says. There's no masks whatsoever. I don't know if the CDC knows that we're doing this for Book Character Day, but you cannot wear a mask tomorrow. That's what this says. That to me is scary and not appropriate, so it's kind of a contradiction there. But in any event, you might be thinking to yourself, who can I go as to school tomorrow? Well, don't need to worry, guys. We actually have a little list here. You can check. We have a fun little list here of just some great book characters you can go as. So take a look really closely and see if you can spot one that you might like to be. Okay. All right, there's a list of book characters for you. All right, well, it is Read Across America Week, guys. And, you know, since reading is fundamental because it's both fun and demental, yes, of course it is. But you know what, guys? Don't take my word for it. Okay. In fact, you shouldn't take my word for this. There is someone whose word you should take, though, and it's our own Miss Campbell. So, with that being said, here's our own Miss Campbell with another installment of her book club.
And now, Miss Campbell presents Miss Campbell's Book Club with Miss Campbell. Here's your host, Miss Campbell.
Hi, I'm Miss Campbell, and did you know today is Dr. Seuss's birthday? Well, what a better way to celebrate his birthday than with reading some great books. Let me show you some from our library. We have a wonderful series of books from Tom Engelberger. They're all on the Star Wars theme, and they are highly recommended by our friends Edward and Michael Kuntz. Mm-hmm. Yep, great books. Take off on the Star Wars theme, so The Surprise Attack of Jabba the Puppet and Princess Labelmaker to the Rescue. Well, in addition to that, boys and girls, Tom Engelberger, the author, also did a folding and doodling guidebook. Yeah, you might enjoy this, so check it out at the library. Here's another favorite series of mine. It's You Choose, and all different kinds of themes. So we have the railroad, building a new nation, a jungle book, okay? Gold Rush, and westward expansion. Fifth grade, are you doing westward expansion yet? Well, let me show you how these work. You start reading, and you'll get to a part where it'll ask you to make a choice. Depending on your choice, it'll send you to different pages. Pretty cool book. You can read it like 100 different times in 100 different ways. Great books. Oh, here's a good one. Do you like reading somebody's diary? Well, that's what these books are written like, reading somebody's diary. When you open it up and start to read, they even have them dated for you. Fantastic books. This one is about a girl who's living during the Civil War time. And this one is about a girl, oh, look at that. Her last name's Campbell, Hattie Campbell. And she lived during the Oregon Trail time, the westward expansion time. Great books. And here's one about a boy who wrote a diary or a journal, if you want to call it that. Yeah, but he was on the Oregon Trail too. For our younger crowd, I picked out some books that are chapter books, but they have lots of, or a decent amount of pictures in it. Let me put it that way. Hey, this is the Dragon Masters series. I forgot, Sir Richard of Cornwall. Oh, Sir Richard of Cornwall. Well, can't go wrong with these. And we have the Owl Diary books. Look at that, they're so colorful, great characters. You can really enjoy the Owl Diaries and the Adventurous Princess in Black, okay? Princess in Black. Look at those great pages. This is a brand new series to our library, so come on down to the library to check them out. I'll see you in the library.
That was Miss Campbell Presents Miss Campbell's Book Club with your host, Miss Campbell.
All right, thanks, Miss Campbell. Well, it's Read Across America Week. I said it like six times now in this one episode. I think you're hopefully getting the idea that it is Read Across America Week. But because it's Read Across America Week and reading is so important, it's now more important than ever to be spelling your words correctly, okay? So with that being said, here is another installment of our segment. That's not how you spell acceptance. That's not how you spell acceptance. You know, I can accept a lot of things. I can accept when I spell Lila Spade wrong. I can accept when I spell Jeremias LeBron wrong. I can accept those things. But the one thing I can't accept is this spelling of acceptance. Ay. All right. Well, I'm just saying the same things over and over again. That's what life kind of is. It's just you say the same things over and over again until you don't anymore. But it's Dr. Seuss's birthday, guys. Hello. Yes, and it's John Bon Jovi's, more importantly. But it also is Dr. Seuss's birthday. I wonder how old he is. I wonder how old he's going to be. Let's look it up. Oh. Oh dear. Well, in any event, let's see how much you know about Dr. Seuss. We're talking so much about Dr. Seuss. Let's see how much you know about him. With a little game that we debuted back in 2016. Let's see how much you know about Dr. Seuss. Our new game, Seuss or Garfield.
You'll get caught up in it.
Follow me?
Yes.
Well, stop following me, or I'll have you arrested.
Alright, well hopefully you did well, because if you didn't, I don't know what to say. Alright, and now, let's head over to Mrs. Smoltz with the weather. Mrs. Smoltz?
Good morning, boys and girls. This is Mrs. Smoltz giving you the weather today. I'm going to start with Super Spring, because it's Read Across America Week. Super Spring goes like this. Springtime, oh springtime. I know when spring is here. It rains a lot and flowers grow. A super time of year. I step outside and feel the breeze. Things start growing on the trees. Springtime, oh springtime, a super time of year. Chirp, chirp, chirp is a sound that you might hear. Tomorrow, it is going to be 39 degrees, but it's gonna be sunny. Make it a great one.
Well, thanks, Mrs. Smoltz. For me and this gigantic kid grabbing the hot air balloon. That kid's like 30 feet tall. Here at Good Morning Union Canal, I'm Mr. Bryson, I'm reminding you to be a superhero and have a great day. All right, another episode done. You know what, this calls for, I'm gonna read a book. It's Read Across America Week, guys. Come on, you gotta read a book. Let's pick this one. Boxcar Children, The Mystery in Washington, D.C. Ooh. Think of a few mysteries from Washington, D.C. All right, let's see here. I can't wait to crack this one open and see what the boxcar children have to say about that. Okay, guys, I think Mr. Zelensky turned off the show. Guys, this is it. Come on. We're writing poems. Have you thought about these poems? Think about it. Oh, Mr. Zelensky, I think that I shall never see a man as lovely as Mr. Z. Hey, I just came up with that. You can't steal it, though. It's mine. I just copyrighted it. Okay, but come up with your own poem and send it to Mr. Zelensky. Give it to your teacher by this Friday so we can mail them to him down in Philadelphia. It'll brighten his mood up. It'll get him ready to coach those Eagles, lead him to the Super Bowl. Maybe he can use some of your poetry to inspire the Eagles players, okay? So, guys, get writing those poems, those short stories. Turn them into your teacher by this Friday. Thanks. Guys, the show's over now. It's done. I'm reading a book now. Can you please leave? I'm trying to read a...